the video at the start of the movie, it's really old school Adam stuff. And Judd, is that you shooting the stuff of Adam making the phone calls and when you guys were roommates together?
Oh yeah, yes. When we were roommates, I used to videotape Adam making phony phone calls for no reason other than I just felt bad that no one else could see it because it was making me laugh. And then when I was looking for old footage to start the movie with, because I wanted to show this character when he was young, I thought maybe I could find that footage. So I had to go through every video I had ever taken. So there's a lot of embarrassing videos other than that. There's a lot of me naked. There's a whole period where I would tape.
That's a whole other rating.
All of my sexcapades, you know. Yeah. I mean, so I had to go through it and watch all that.
You did alone. That was fun. Yeah.
But obviously you knew Adam was going to be big, so you always said, Adam's going to be the man, Adam's going to be a big star. Is that what you were filming?
He banked on that.
He banked on that, because it's days before YouTube as well, so is that what you were filming?
I had invented YouTube in my mind, so I knew that one day I could put those phony phone calls on YouTube. I just couldn't get anyone to buy it from me.
I like having a girlfriend. I don't have one, but I like it better. One night stands are tough, and I'm not great at sex, so at the end of every time I got to look at him and go, hey, normally I do better than that. Girlfriends are so much better, you know. You finish up and you're just like, well, you know. That's how I do it.
And Adam, how was it working with your old roommate? Oh, last time I spoke to you for Bedtime Stories, you were about halfway through filming, I think.
Right.
And how's it like? Has it been directed by your friend?
It was excellent. I gave myself up to Apatow. I don't usually do that. I usually yell at people and say, I'm not doing that, let me do this. But Apatow, I said, I'll do anything you want me to do, kid.
Okay, because a lot has been made over the kind of slight change in tone of the movie, because it leans more towards drama, but it's funny as well, obviously.
I think it's more funny than dramatic, but there are scenes that are heavy.
Yeah. It's too early to know who's winning the fight, the medicine or the disease.
Did anybody ever tell you a very scary accent?
You are a very funny man. I enjoy your movies.
And I enjoy all of your movies.
Which movies?
The ones where you try to kill Bruce Willis.
But because it has been like kind of referred to as a dramatic movie, did you guys feel much pressure kind of coming in? Because you're both obviously coming off a lot of successful movies, a lot of successful comedies. Did you guys feel much pressure coming into it? Especially you, Judd, coming off two smashes have been accredited with the R-rated, you know, creating the R-rated comedy.
Well, I just thought I have some freedom to do stuff now, and it's a good moment to be even more creative and ambitious and to do something really personal with Adam and Leslie and Jonah and Seth and my kids. So it is a, you know, a more ambitious movie, but I think it has more rewards. Hopefully, you know, you don't forget about it by the time you get to your car in the parking lot. You think about it for a month later. It makes you laugh, and then it haunts you, which is what you want it to do.
Don't shake us.
And what about these young guys? You obviously got Jonah Hill, Seth Rogen, you got Jason Schwartzman. But we spoke to Kevin James back in Dublin in March, and he's astounded by how funny these guys are at such a young age. Judd, you're obviously used to these guys at this stage, but Adam, how did you find working with the guys?
No, they really are quite knowledgeable.
From mid-20s.
I know. They're very confident, funny, sweet people. Really, baffled how nice they are. I was, when I got success at that age, I was a little more cocky than them. They maintain some sweetness.
Okay. And a lot's been made as well, you know, improvisation. Judd, you're accredited again with, you know, the improv comedy. Improv, is it another art form in itself, editing down and choosing what's funny? Picking out, like, if Adam's riffing or if Seth's riffing.
It's a ton of work to try to reconstruct everything after the fact, but I always feel like when people are together and they're really funny, if you have like Adam and Seth and they have like a moment, I'd be crazy not to let them play a little bit. Yeah. And for me to, you know, pitch them ideas and them to, you know, try things that they think of, because they're all great writers. You know, Adam wrote a ton of his movies. Seth wrote Superbad, Pineapple Express. I'd be a moron to not say, hey, what are you guys thinking? Because I know I'm going to take the credit at the end of the day anyway.
Yeah.
And I won't thank them. When the awards come, I don't thank anybody.
He thanked me by kissing me.
And what's next for both of you guys finally here? Adam, I know you're shooting the movie with a bunch of other comedians. A bunch of pals.
Kevin James, Chris Rock, David Spade, Rob Schneider, Salma Hayek, Maria Bello. Maya Rudolph, a lot of people.
That's a crazy amount of comedians.
It was so much fun to do a movie without Judd. It was incredible. Everybody was like, Judd's not involved. Everyone's
signed. What about you, Judd? Are you planning on writing and directing anything?
No, I'm going to take a nap. for about 8 months, and then I'm going to see what happens. I produced a movie called Get Him to the Greek with Russell Brand and Jonah Hill and my new best friend, Sean P. Diddy Combs. I'm excited for that. That comes out next year.
Okay. Well, guys, thank you for taking time to speak to us. Really appreciate
Thanks, buddy.
It's good to see you again, Adam.
Good to see you, too.
Nice to meet you, Joe.
Nice to see you.